they're trying to end the final salary pension scheme and bring in performance-related pay and no guaranteed pay rise every year. That's even for the lower grades.
A large proportion of the staff will have their pay in effect frozen for anything up to 5 to 10 years. People year on year will be losing money, which will then have a knock-on effect in terms of their pension. At the moment, they negotiate pay with the trade unions on an annual basis, and people get a consolidated pay rise, which goes into their pension. What they're seeking to do is, in the large part, replace that with just a one-off bonus. So people's salaries really will be staying static for up to 5 or 10 years. It can have an impact of tens of thousands of pounds upon people over the time that they're working at TfL.
The company's told us that we're overpaid. They've done some market research against external companies, and they reckon that for the similar skills they're paying too much.
If you were going to do a market comparison with TfL, you would think perhaps you might compare it with organisations or companies that provide transport in some of the largest capitals across the world. In fact, TfL have compared wages with companies like Walt Disney and companies like Amazon. And Amazon have got an absolutely appalling record. Their working conditions have been described as like a slave camp.
These places are ununionised, they haven't got any collective bargaining, so they want to bring everybody down to the lowest level, you know.
I'm very highly skilled, a lot of my colleagues are highly skilled. To try and compare us with people like Amazon, John Lewis, and Argos, I don't really see where they're coming from. Senior managers are happy to award themselves 50% of their salary as pay rises, and yet they say that I'm overpaid.
At the last count, there was 1,000 of them earning over £100,000, a couple of them earning over £250,000, and a few of them earning more than £500,000. When they did this market review, these people on £500,000 weren't getting paid enough.
I fail to see how some of our senior managers can earn 4 times the salary of David Cameron.
People that work for TfL keep London moving. They provide an essential service, often in the background, sometimes in the forefront in places like travel information centres, actually keeping London moving, you know, stopping gridlock, dealing with incidents and traffic accidents every single day. You know, they work really hard. A lot of people have dedicated their entire working life to TfL.
I've been here for 22 years, never been on strike, but I'm certainly not happy about the way the company wants to change my terms and conditions without any consultation whatsoever.
TfL have actually refused to negotiate with the trade unions about it. And have refused, unlike London Underground, they've refused to go to ACAS to even try and, you know, reach some form of agreement. So what they're proposing to do is to actively impose it upon staff.
These proposals don't allow for any discussion. That's what the company's going to do, and you're stuck with it, and I'm not happy about it.
Yes, sir. We've never even balloted for action before, let alone taken strike action and action short of strike. It's a really historic moment, and I think it does demonstrate the strength of feeling amongst the staff at TfL. You know, not only that they're on strike, but so many people here, just ordinary union members, have actually come out. And we've had masses of people joining the union, even in the last 2 or 3 days, specifically so that they can take this strike action. Over half of the staff at TfL regularly, as in every week, work unpaid overtime. So staff members will be taking action short of strike, which will mean working their ordinary hours. And this is the first day of strike action. There will be more strike action.
It's fantastic to see that we've got the RMT, TSSA and Unite all on the same picket line, fighting this together. If this doesn't work, we're going to have to up the ante. We're going to have more strikes.
It's very good to see the three unions working together, because it's an attack on all our terms and conditions and pensions.